But James, congratulations. Can't beat a last over victory.
Yeah, outstanding win. Especially as we probably didn't play our best cricket. And that's a sign of a good team if you win when you're not playing your good cricket. So hopefully we can keep this form going.
Had a right rollicking start, especially with Steve Mullaney hitting it everywhere. Then some wickets crashed, and that meant you had to play what I might call an unusual 2020 innings, a slowish start and then picking it up.
Yeah, massively slow start, but we had a massive black cloud over my head when I thought it was going to rain the whole time, and the fact that we lost three wickets. So if we lost four wickets and I was out, we were in a real dire situation. So I thought I had to see it through as much as I could. I didn't plan on having that many dot balls, but never mind. I picked it up and got the team to a decent score in the end and a manageable total that I thought we could definitely defend.
Your bowling unit looked outstanding tonight. Everyone seems to know their job and pulls it off to the letter.
Yeah, that's the key. The guys knowing their roles, and they're outstanding tonight. Like I said before, with a wet ball, to nail those Yorkers at the end when we needed to, when the side needed them to do it, was outstanding. Luke Fletcher and Harry Gurney, those last two overs. But Ajmal Shehzad also did a great job.
Now, Steve Mullaney took an outstanding catch. So did Sam Wood at the end there. A couple of belters taken. Sam looked like he did himself a mischief at the end.
Yeah, I think he got winded slash hurt his rib. And to be fair, I think that won us the game, that catch. Had that gone for four or six, we were out the game. So an outstanding catch when we really needed to. And he had serious pressure on him out on the boundary there. But outstanding catch and another great catch from Mullaney after that little mishap before.
And Chris Reid, sharp bit of stumping behind the timbers there.
Yeah, there's still life in the old dog. He's a great keeper, one of the best in the country still. He's been great all season behind the stumps. And it's nice to have him helping me as me as captain and him helping me out.
Now, the coach has said that given Notts' record in quarterfinals at home over the last few years, he'd rather be playing away. Surely you want to play at Trent Bridge, don't you?
I think he's saying that because our record at home in the quarterfinals has been pretty poor. But no, we definitely do want a quarterfinal. And the fact is, if we play good cricket and our best cricket, we'll win. So that's what I'm planning on if we do get to the quarterfinals. But we still get three big games to come that hopefully we can win them.
I'd love to be back here at Edgbaston for finals day.
Yeah, exactly. What a great venue this is. And I've been lucky enough to play on a finals day before here with Leicestershire. And I know the atmosphere is unbelievable. So fingers crossed, there's a lot of cricket to play before then, but fingers crossed we can get here.
Okay, well, congratulations tonight. We'll play.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Well, Stephen, congratulations. Busy old night for you. Bit of early hitting to begin with, and then a drop catch, which you won't dwell on, but an absolute stunner to put that right.
Yeah, thank you very much. Yeah, I obviously had the chance at the top of the order tonight with Michael Lum's injury. Obviously gutted the other night to not get the chance at Durham, but it's something I really enjoyed doing, and if there's a chance in the future, I'd like to do it again.
A little bit disappointed perhaps not to go on because you made an absolutely rifling start.
Yeah, I was, because I knew obviously where Boyd was going to bowl with the field he set. I just tried to get it, obviously get this out of it and hit it to the short boundary, but it just stuck in the pitch a little bit, and I probably should have just pulled out of the shot rather than go through with it and obviously take my medicine and carry on.
Now, the catch that went down, as though we're not going to dwell on it, but you got a little bit of stick from behind in the old south stand, but did that spur you on to take the one you did get?
Yeah, well, I obviously had to make up for that one. It was a terrible bit of fielding, and it was nice to hang on to the other one. But most important thing is that we've got 2 points and we're pushing up that table and getting closer to a quarter-final spot.
And how good was the bowling unit overall for the Outlaws?
I thought it was absolutely tremendous from start to finish. We obviously had a couple of boundaries, which happens in 2020, but I thought Luke Fletcher's last over and Harry's penultimate over were, if there's better death bowler than Luke Fletcher at Yorkers, I'd like to see him.
So it looks like you're almost there in terms of quarterfinals. How important would it be for you and the team to play at home?
Yeah, well, we've had a home quarterfinal the last 4 years and we've lost three of them, but we'd rather play at home than away. So, oh, look, we'll just try and continue this great form that we're in this competition, and then hopefully get that home quarterfinal. If not, then we'll go away and try and win there.
A great performance tonight. Well played.
Thank you. Cheers.